Communication, our paper is mobile devices as learning tools, present and prospective used by future professionals of education. The use of mobile devices is increasing and creating new scenarios for communication, teaching and learning where students are increasingly involved. In this process, digital competence is an ability that transcends those acquired in the classroom and becomes a socio-communicative competition as students use mobile devices as tools of communication. Our goal is to make these pedagogic tools that are communicative
Es el problema de la universidad.
The main objective of this study is understand the relevance of mobile devices as learning resources in university classroom of the degrees study. And the specific objectives are knowing the degree of awareness of students about the potential of mobile devices to acquire skills and knowledge. Knowing the self-perception of students on the mastery of didactic and methodological possibilities of mobile devices. Get information about whether the interaction with mobile devices is easy and flexible. Time, location for students, making it style of quiet relation and delivery of work in the subjects. Understand the impact of mobile devices on the teacher-students and student-students interaction. Now the prospect of incorporation of mobile devices in the future teaching profession of students. And finally, get information about presence and degree of penetration of the use of mobile devices as learning tools in an environment of higher education. Our hypothesis is that even if the use of these devices remains merely playful and communicative by students at the university level, they are aware of the many potentialities of this device, although they do not have used them as learning tools inside or outside the classroom, but would do at the right moment. We have followed a quantitative methodology and non-experimental methods of descriptive type together with a questionnaire as the technique for data collection. The instrument used to analyze the current and prospective use that is made of mobile devices as learning tools by degree and master students has been the questionnaire. The questionnaire has 21 items in a Likert scale from 0 to 5. Where 0 is strongly disagree and 5 strongly agree. This instrument is divided in two blocks. The block 1, items 1 to 6, restores the perception of the students about their digital competence. And the block 2, items 7 to 21, restores the perception of the students on their proficiency in the use of mobile devices in the classroom.
The sample we've used for these studies, all composed by students who are now enrolled in a degree or master's degree at the University of Salamanca and who will be teachers either of pre-primary, primary or secondary education in a near future. So our fourth year students of primary and pre-primary education, childhood education, and master's degree in education students who will be taking their oposiciones or their professional career next year. So are about to be egresados from the University of Salamanca, either in grado or in postgraduate studies. We had 24 studies from the fourth year of the degree and 30 students from the master's degree in secondary education teachers. Both groups, the undergrad students, were studying a specialty in English. The reason why they were chosen because of being future teachers of English, first of all, this is because they are the students we have available, because these are the students I teach English, and secondly, because English is one of the subjects where new technologies and mobile devices have penetrated with a higher perception or a higher density. So we want to know how these future teachers of tomorrow, perceive their own competence in using the devices and how well they think they will use them in the classroom with the kids. Well, regarding the first block, how well they think they use the mobile devices, it is surprising this orange bar here that is answers, I don't know if you can read it, this is quite small, answers the item, I would like to get information about mobile devices possibilities to improve my learning process. So they're aware of the potentiality of these mobile devices, but they still claim to have more information of how they could use mobile devices to improve their own learning process. So they're aware that they have to learn the competence that we are now using everywhere, but they need to know how they can do it using the mobile devices. The second item that is highlighted as well is the blue one, the last one that says, I am aware of the relevance of mobile devices as learning tools. So I know I can learn through mobile devices, but please tell me how. Regarding the second block, the second part is how well I think I would implement my teaching practice with mobile devices. Is outstanding this one there that says, I think mobile devices are useful for teaching and learning processes. So is something generally or globally acknowledged that mobile devices are a reality and should be something within the class and within the classroom? They have done both masters and undergrad students their practical periods at schools, and they have touched and felt the reality of the classrooms being mobile devices included, as tablets, as mini PCs, or even as mobile devices in the last years of primary education and secondary education. As the second outstanding result over there, it responds to mobile devices would favor a faster and fuller acquisition of professional competences. So not only would I learn by using mobile devices, but I think I would be a better professional. So it's something related as well to something that is now in the mouth of everyone, that is employability for our students, how well they will be employed when they finish studying with us at universities. And this is something related to that. The more they use the mobile devices in the university classroom, the better they will be prepared to cope with the professional their professional action. Regarding some of the items, because this is a really small presentation, regarding some of the items which were really representative, it is something outstanding as well that in this item 5, I mastered the didactic and methodological part of mobile devices, improving my learning process, doing practical tasks and looking for information. The results for the master studies in blue were significantly higher than those from the undergrad students. So that means, or that is significant, that the preparation of a master's for a teaching career is not only necessary, but also positive for the students. So secondary students have their degree and then a master's, but primary and pre-primary students only have the degree. There is not a master's for primary education teacher or something, as we have for secondary education teacher. So are they in a different disposition when they finish their degrees? It seems so. It seems that they need the master, to enhance and to solidify, in some sense, their knowledge of and the use of modern web systems. Regarding this other item that was significant, item 9, I would use mobile devices to acquire new competences related to my future career. So I would learn things that I would use in my future as a teacher. Okay? Masters is again higher than the undergrad. There is nothing that surprises us because we've said and we've seen the results before. But if we analyze the degree they come from, okay, it is significantly higher in these degrees, green, of primary education, than on the blue one, which is pre-primary education. So the fact and the penetration that mobile devices have done in Spanish schools, that is the ones they know and the experience they have, in primary education is significantly higher than in primary education as they perceive and is perceived by students who will be devoting and developing that profession in a near future. If we go to another item that was outstanding, item 12, the use of mobile devices can make handling essays in my subject easier and quicker. We're moving to another territory, that is us, the university teachers, using mobile devices as resources to train them into handling essays, into developing digital competences at university, because we are sometimes asking them to use the mobile devices in their classroom with the kids, and we ourselves are not using the mobile devices in our subject. So modeling and using the devices in the university allows them to be able to implement and to use them afterwards. Okay? And more or the same results are thrown by this analysis. Significant difference between the master's and the degree students, and also a significant difference between the master's degree here in yellowish brownish and the primary and pre-primary education students. So it seems that the perception of how well I use mobile devices and how well I will use mobile devices depends on the type of students they will teach, either pre-primary, primary or secondary students, and also on the preparation they have either through a master's that is specific for didactic and pedagogical reasons, or the degree they're doing on that specialty. If we go to this final item, item 13, I think I wouldn't have relevant difficulties when using mobile devices as complementary tools for learning. We again find the same or more or less results in the same line, which are higher and significantly higher for those students in the master's than or compared to those undergraduate ones. If we had to draw some conclusions of this very small peel of the analysis and the project we are doing, we could say that regarding block one, the digital competence is a skill they consider to be key in their teaching and learning process. So they recognize that it's something that is essential, that is the basis for the learning process, and they're fully aware that within that learning and teaching process, mobile devices have a relevant position. Okay, so the awareness of the student is already there. They're also aware of the benefits at functional and pedagogical levels of mobile devices, and even if they perceive themselves as mastering the mobile devices, they say they wouldn't have problems, they feel that they are more or less competent users, they still claim more training and orientation on the specific uses and implementations of mobile devices within the class. So I know how to use the mobile devices, but maybe I don't know how to use the mobile devices as pedagogical tools. So it's something we are pursuing. They still use mobile devices for communicative, for playful activities. They know they can use them to learn, but they still don't know how to transfer into that theoretical idea into practical ideas. And regarding block two, the use of mobile devices into the daily or the application within the class, there are no differences according to gender or to age, so that means there are no differences. Everybody's aware, more or less in the same degree, And there is a comparable tendency in perception, valuation, and use. If we go to these other items that were significant, it seems that both undergraduate and master students show a positive aptitude. As I said before, the attitude is increasingly positive as students get more prepared. So master's degree are more aware and more ready and more prepared to implement and to use mobile devices than undergraduate students. They're ready to use mobile devices to acquire new competences within the university environment and to apply those competences outside the university in their professional practices. Concerning the difficulties they think they perceive they would have, they show a tendency to manifest or to call for more training, for more orientation, and for more application and inclusion of technologies within the classroom. So these practices we've been seeing here today, including mobile devices into the university classrooms, are still scarce within universities, and they perceive we are asking them to use mobile devices that we ourselves don't use so much, or they use in a consistent way. So this is more or less the study we've done to know and to be able to ask students to do something with mobile devices, knowing beforehand what they think, how they feel, and what is their perception. Okay? Thank you very much for your attention.